Hey, what's up there, Nibble Nuts?
Yo.
Jerky Boys in this bit. Hey, shout out if you've ever heard of the Jerky Boys.
Nope.
You gotta watch some old school Jerky Boys. Prank call, that's like the original prank stuff.
Prank calls,
yeah. Incredible. Anyways, my name is Don, that's Samuel Lee. We are the Soul Brothers. We bring to you shoe news, reviews, basketball talk, and whatnot. And we also have a dog named Raina.
And whatnot.
So we're going to hop into a versus video. This is a dope versus video.
It is. Okay. A lot of you guys are asking for it,
yeah,
too.
Which is a smart ask because these are two really good shoes. We're going to put them toe-to-toe. They're both Adidas shoes. They're both brand new. This is the Adidas D-Rose 7 versus...
the Crazy Explosive.
So let's hop right in.
It's crazy.
It's crazy wild, you know? Wild Explosive is
wild
the new model.
Wild Explosive. Hyper.
Yes. So let's hop in on the traction real quick. Both of these are pretty good traction, but this one is just...
the D-Rose 7 is just one of the best tractions I've ever used.
Yeah.
You know, durability-wise, they both suck ass.
Yeah.
Because I only played indoors
this
with...
this one's getting eaten up.
Yeah, so the D-Rose 7, the rubber's already fraying off.
Yeah.
And same with the fucking Crazy Explosive, which is crazy.
That might be a price you pay for having such good traction.
Yeah, it's
maybe,
weird.
I don't know.
See all this shit, like, fraying off
and
stuff?
Yeah, these are real...
like, it's just indoor use, too. It's just indoor use.
Yeah, we're just playing indoors.
Exactly. So, durability, it sucks. So, don't play outdoors with either of these shoes. Traction, the D-Rose 7 has way more bite, but then the Crazy Explosive is still a good, really good traction. You know?
Yeah, and I don't even really wipe with this shoe
exactly.
either.
Exactly. Same with the Crazy Explosive, right?
I wipe a little bit.
A little bit
more than this, but...
Wiping dust is really good, as in, like, it doesn't get stuck on these shoes.
Mm-hmm.
So, wiping is basically non-existent. But the one thing that the D-Rose 7 wins in traction is the bite.
Yeah.
You know, so the D-Rose 7 soft way harder than the Crazy Explosive, so... durability-wise, they're both basically the same. I would say the Crazy Explosive is a little worse.
Yeah.
A little worse, you know?
Yeah.
But
This shit grabs so hard. And even the way that the outsole is done, this outrigger here is cool, is really cool.
Yeah.
And a lot of the traction wraps around a little bit. I mean, it does here too.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, when you consider the amount of bite this has, it's really just, it's just better. So... now, moving on, these are both full-length Boost.
Yes, sir.
However, they do feel differently.
Yep.
So, in the D-Rose, you know, it's nice. They caged it quite a bit, actually, in the heel. You can see there's actually more Boost here underneath this, like, this heel counter that kind of wraps around to the midsole. And then even the outsole rubber kind of wraps around and cages various parts of the Boost. It was a lot less caged in the sixth, and you could feel a lot better. Some people may like that, some people may not like that. I like to feel a little bit more, but it's still really good.
Yeah.
I would say better than the, in my opinion, I would take the cushion in this over the Crazy Explosive.
Yeah, the Crazy Explosive is crazy caged, you know?
Yeah.
It's hella caged in the lateral side of the shoe. On the medial side, it's not caged at all, besides the kind of the rubber right here. But yeah, definitely you can't feel really the Boost at all in the heel. But I'm actually not mad at that because I really want to. It's a Crazy Explosive, so you want to be explosive in the shoe. You want the cushion, the whole entire shoe to be responsive. If you want that, you can't have any dead play in the cushion at all. You know, so even in the heel, you can barely feel it. But the good thing about this setup is that the impact protection is crazy good, you know.
Yeah.
So impact protection is really good. Heel to toe transition in both of the shoes is really good. What I would take, I would take the D-Rose 7 because I can feel the Boost in the heel slightly more. It feels more similar to the Crazy Light Boost 2016.
Yep.
You know, but this one you can't really feel the Boost at all. So D-Rose 7 for the win. But if you want total responsiveness, then go with the Crazy Explosive.
Yes. Okay, moving on to the upper. Now there is a prime knit version of the D-Rose 7. We don't have it in yet. We will get it and test it. But the main difference here is you got a bunch of mesh and some synthetic materials, and then you got full length prime knit that Sammy's mother, grandmother actually knitted for him.
Yep.
This is each shoe is knitted handmade by an elderly lady.
Yep.
So it's a real nice material.
Yep.
And it's better. It's just better materials.
It's so soft, yeah. Man. Like, it's just material wise, yeah. Prime Knit wins. It's super soft, but it's actually pretty supportive where it needs to be.
Yeah.
Especially because it's caged right here with this kind of material, mm-hmm. And this is where you need support when you're doing cuts and shit. And then this is what they're calling GeoFit.
Yeah.
And the GeoFit is basically a neoprene upper, kind of like the D-Leather tooth. And it goes right over your foot and gives you more support, while the Prime Knit kind of, overlays that, mm-hmm. And it feels basically like a sock.
So, yeah. Well, that brings us right into fit.
Yep.
Crazy explosive for a big time win.
I think this is one of the best fitting shoes.
Yes.
For me, you know, for because sure. It can be super tight in the toe area, the toe box, but then it's Prime Knit and it's stretchy, so yeah. That it gives a little bit more. And you have that really tight feeling, and you have that really tight feeling all over your foot with yeah. This shoe, so the fit is amazing. There's actually a good amount of toe space, you know, in the toe box area.
Yeah, there really is. Not lengthwise. Lengthwise, they actually run a little small.
Mm-hmm.
We were having issues with our toes hitting. We went down a half a size, so I would say definitely go true to size, maybe even half a size up. But this is for the mesh model. In the Prime Knit model, you're probably not gonna have any problems with that,
yeah,
because it's such a soft upper that even if you hit it with your toe, it's not gonna hurt that bad.
Yep.
But the fit was just not fully there in the D-Rose 7 for
exactly.
me.
Exactly.
So that's a for sure win.
And go down half a size for the Crazy Explosive.
Yes.
I did. Someone did comment. I forgot your name. Sorry, but they said the problem was with the D-Rose 7 was because of the insole. But then I'll try that out and we'll see if that.
Oh, changing the insole?
Changing the insole. He said changing the insole will help with the toe box problem. So,
nah, dog.
You don't think so? Mm-hmm. Maybe it'll raise you up, and then because, you know, there's so much space in the toe area, maybe it'll raise you up and maybe it'll be
your
a
toe's
bit
just
going
to be closer to the
really?
To the upper in the toe. Mm-hmm. The problem is it's real hard. Another one of the problems.
Yeah.
Right. So if your toe hits here, it's like this Prime Knit is still kind of soft.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a mystery. Maybe that works. I don't know, the insole thing. I wouldn't think that would work for my pair.
Uh-huh.
I need to just go back up to my normal size.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm actually going to do that. Okay, so let's move on to support. That's a win for the D-Rose 7.
Yep.
D-Rose, you know, he's big on support. And this is a pretty high shoe. And there's a lot more ankle support and stronger materials around the ankle.
Yep.
And these materials have less give if you're doing cuts and being explosive and stuff, even though that's a crazy explosive shoe.
Yep.
If you're real explosive and you want to protect your explosive bones, then you might want to have to pick up this shoe. But now let's touch on
Lockdown. Lockdown goes to Crazy Explosive.
Yeah.
Because there's no heel slippage really at all in any either of the shoes. But the Lockdown here in the toe area, obviously the toe problem, they should have probably gone down one more eyelid,
yeah,
you know, so you can
sure.
tighten it a little bit more or added a fucking tongue. I don't know why they made it one booty upper, because it's exactly like we've always been saying, one booty upper. If it does not fit your foot correctly, then you're fucked,
yeah.
You know? So, yeah.
Lockdown, I think there's a slight issue in this shoe with Lockdown. You know, yeah, bringing another eyelid down, the whole one booty upper thing, and it just wasn't there. So, there it is.
Crazy Explosive.
Crazy Explosive. Now we're going to touch on ventilation real quick. That shoe is hot as hell.
It's pretty hot because of the Prime Knit. So D-Rose 7 for the win.
Yep.
Moving on to aesthetics, I would go with the D-Rose 7.
Me too.
This is actually kind of growing on me, but still kind of ugly. It looks like a boot, you know?
Yeah.
So there you go. And then durability-wise, they both suck, you know?
Yeah.
Now, I don't think it would last, but I think
the outsoles at least.
Yeah, the outsoles. But the D-Rose 7, I think the materials would be a little bit better.
Yeah, a little stronger.
A little bit stronger.
See, the Prime Knit is like, you know, it's pretty good material, but it starts to stretch over time.
Exactly.
Obviously, you know, it's just a textile knit.
Yeah.
Okay, let's touch on weight real quick.
Okay. So the D-Rose 7, they're both size 7.
Right.
Okay. And then the Crazy Explosive is 13.83.
Uh-huh.
And then the D-Rose 7 is 14.81.
Ooh.
Yeah, so
that's a heavy shoe.
Yeah.
The D-Rose, that's a heavy shoe.
The D-Rose 7 is 1 whole ounce heavier.
And it doesn't feel like the lightest shoe.
Yeah.
To me either, you know.
It's a little bulky.
It's a little bulky and the fit isn't totally there.
This one, you feel hella light.
Hella light.
Oh my god. Like, it's the crazy. Primeknit, I think the feeling of light is mostly due to the fit. The fit and yeah. the, what kind
it's
of
It's mostly just placebo. Yeah. It's the weight really doesn't even matter. It's how they're, because you can't really notice an ounce or two.
Or two, yeah.
You know, but like, you know, if they do the fit right and the cushion right and everything, it just feels super, super light.
And I think another segment we should put in is comfort.
Yeah.
You know, what's a more comfortable shoe?
Yeah.
I would have to say the Crazy Explosive, the upper is really comfortable. It feels really nice when it goes over your foot and stretches over your foot. But the Boost, I would say, the Beetle 7 yeah. is more comfortable. So yeah. Whatever you want, there you go.
Yeah. All right. So wrapping it up, price-wise, the D-Rose, you're looking at $140.
And then the Crazy Explosive is $150.
$150.
So basically the same.
Basically the same. That shoe, I would hands down go with the Crazy Explosive.
Crazy Explosive,
That man. Shoe is a smash hit. They really did something right there. Not saying this is a bad shoe. That's just how good this shoe is, and that's after saying how much better this traction is, and the cushion's a little better. You know, it does have its points where it is better, but you know that shoe all around is just, they did something right there.
Mm-hmm.
So we definitely recommend that. We recommend both of them, but Crazy Light, Crazy Light, Crazy Explosive, for the win.
Yep, for the winter.
For the dub. Yeah.
Winter is what I just said.
Yes.
But anyways, thank you guys for watching. Hope we helped you guys out on your next purchase. And if you guys have any other suggestions for versus videos, leave them in the comment section below. Make sure to subscribe and like the video, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
Later.
Peace.